Hey folks, it's Brian. It's time for another junky truck video. So I'm working on the wiring, and tonight I'm going to start building the cable harness to go from the glow plug controller to the glow plugs. Spent a long time studying this, and the glow plugs should pull 15 amps a piece, which is 144 amps net when they're at full load. So I'm going to bring main cables over to here and mount this block right here. So anyway, let me get started on this. So I think there's plenty of space here. Now I'm going to use a carbide scribe to mark where I think this thing should go. And so I'm thinking about right there. Yep. That'll bring it in. It's gonna be a little tight, but I think it'll work. Now, it would be a fool's errand to work on this in place. So I'm going to pull this strap off so I can take this thing in and work on it in the machines, because I actually have machine tools and I can make short work out of this in my air conditioned garage. That looks like a good place for that. Whole filter assembly is in a really honestly a stupid place. Damn it. Looking at this, trying to figure out if that's really where I want to put it. This mount bracket is really tempting, but then I've got throttle cables down there. We get over here on this side, but then I've got to jack with this whole thing while it's on truck. Is space here on the side, but then it's going to be in the way when I go to change the filter. There's just really not a nice place to put this up here, which is weird. And I really do think putting it in this vicinity somewhere is a good spot for it. There, so I think I'm gonna build a bracket for it and put it up here. So let's go work on that. We're gonna build it out of steel. All right, so this is what's gonna get used. It came out of my scrap bin. I think both sides are the same size. Yeah, it's a little bit long, and I don't feel like pulling my metal cutoff saw out just to cut this. I don't know, I should. All right, let me think about it for a second. it's time to get this thing set up, so I'm going to put it in time-lapse mode while I do that. Well, thanks to the wonders of fucking up with GoPro, y'all missed me drilling and tapping these. Sorry. So I'm lining up the scribe mark I made when it was on the vehicle. And then I'm just making scribe marks here that'll set this where I want it. So the good news is we got a lot to do, so not gonna be any shortage of things to mark here. So what we're going to do is we're going to come in with a 5/16 bit and just randomly drill a couple holes in this. Actually, no, we're not. We're going to come in with a 3/16 bit and drill a couple holes because we're going to thread this. That'll make the other side easier to get to. Yeah, I think. If I'm wrong, I'll just drill out what I tap. Yeah, that ain't right. Thank you. Mark these with this, but this is really not designed for this. Looks like that might be a little softer. That's right, so I'm going to put the phase converter on. Let's drill this puppy. Liking this drill. don't really have a good solution for chips yet. It looks okay. I think that's too big of a screw. So let's find the right size screws. These look pretty good. Look real nice. So let's just go ahead and put this together. After all, this is not really a machining video, this is a truck video. But for all my friends that are like, what the fuck do you own a machine tool for? Why do you have a big lathe and a big mill? What are you going to do with those? Yeah, well, here's your answer. Whatever the hell I want. When I decide I want to make something, I want to be able to make it and not have a crappy little drill press and not have limitations with my tools. I like having tools that are capable of the job, even if I have a crappy ass workspace. I realize some of you do not have an air conditioned shop with 3-phase power, so my definition of crappy workspace and your definition of crappy workspace might be in 2 different places. All right, let me get cleaned up and then we'll get that electrical terminal mounted. Non-ratchet one's making my hand hurt, so I'm just switching it out for a ratchet. And apparently that one's rounded off, so in the trash it goes. Alright, so I'm not 100% sure what I'm catching on video because the GoPro is not doing what I'm expecting it to do today. We're here. Yeah, I think we're where we want to be. So, there we have it. We have mounted this bracket. This will go back in the truck. It's probably, I don't know. Let's see if it's light out still. All right, it's not completely dark yet. So, we're gonna get this thing put back together. Come on. All right, folks, that's it. So the next step will be to run cable from here to there. And let me reroute this. So that's it for tonight. Thanks for watching. Hope you found this useful and entertaining.